It's Pascal's triangle. You know, sometimes I just like to sit and look at it. There's so much cool stuff here. Do you see it? You see all the cool stuff? It's not just a bunch of numbers, all sorts of cool patterns. You don't see it, do you? I'm gonna show you a little bit of the cool stuff, just a little bit, and then you see if you can find some more cool stuff. What I'm gonna show you here is what happens when we add up each row. Right? Oh, I see so much cool stuff here. What happens? Let's see, first row, we add up the first row, we get one. Okay, one. That's not very interesting, but we're gonna write it down anyway. First row gives us one. One plus one is two. All right, still not very interesting. Bear with me. Well, we're going somewhere with this. One plus two plus one, that's four. One plus three plus one, eight. Starting to see a pattern over there. 1 plus 4 plus 6 is 11, plus 4 is 15, plus 1, 16. But you know what number's ending up right there. 1 plus 5 plus 10, 16. 10 plus 5 plus 1 is still 16. 16 and 16 is 32. Powers of 2. Check that out. 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. Will that next number be 64? You can go ahead and check it out. Sure enough, it's 64. Powers of 2 in these rows? And you should be wondering. I hope you're wondering. What's up with that? Why is that happening? You know, what is making these numbers add up to powers of two? So do you see the powers of two now? I see the powers of two. That's very cool. But why is it true? Now, when I look at this, I don't just see powers of two. What I see in these numbers are combinations. So you've seen before these rows in Pascal's triangle are combinations. 5 choose 0, 5 choose 1, 5 choose 2. Let's go ahead and write down this row. And this is what I see when I look at Pascal's triangle. And I see all these cool patterns in combinations. And here the pattern that we're looking at is what happens when we add all of these. And we want to try to figure out why does this give us a power of 2. So this is kind of unusual. Now, when I discover something new or run into something new, well, I don't think I'm so brilliant that I can just figure out why it's true. What I try to do when I hit something new and I don't know how to solve the problem is I just try to relate it to something I already know how to do. So what do we already know how to do that looks like this? It looks like adding up a bunch of combinations, a bunch of terms in which, well, the number we're choosing from is always the same. Where have we seen that before? And this is a big step in problem solving, right? This is how I get through a lot of problems, is just, where have I seen it before? Have I seen anything like this before? Because I sure don't want to start from the beginning to figure out why this is happening. And we've seen this before. We have seen this before, kind of giving it away, right? The lesson, it's called a binomial theorem lesson. Should have been a bit of a clue. We've seen this in the binomial theorem. When we raise a binomial to some power, we get a bunch of terms with these combinations in them where we're always choosing from the same number. So let's go ahead and write down the binomial theorem, raise a binomial to the fifth power, and see if we can figure out what's going on here. I'm going to go ahead and erase all the triangle, except for this last row. I'm leaving that last row we wrote up. So I want to write down the binomial theorem and see why this is happening. So we're going to write it down for raising a binomial theorem to the fifth power. Because we want to get combinations with these fives in them. So this is 5 choose 0 times x to the fifth. And all we're doing is writing out the binomial theorem for raising to the fifth power so we can get all the combinations that we have in this sum down here. And sure enough, we're going to get every single one of them. But we're also going to get all this extra stuff, too. We've got these annoying X's and Y's. That's a problem. Because down here, we don't have any X's and Y's. No X's, no Y's. But we have X's and Y's up here. But we do have all the combinations we wanted. The 5 choose 0, the 5 choose 1, all the way up to the 5 choose 5. So we found something that has a sum with all these combinations in it. We've got all this extra junk. How do we get rid of the extra junk? How do we get rid of the x and y? Well, this is true for every x and y. No matter what I pick for x and y, I get this equation. It's x plus y to the fifth equals all this stuff over here. We want the x's and y's to go away over here. What do we pick to make these go away and just leave the combinations? We just let them both be one. Perfectly legal, x and y can be anything up here. So if I let x and y both equal 1, this comes out to be 1 plus 1 to the 5th. Ha ha ha, power of 2. We are barking at the right tree, and all the x's and y's over here go away. We just have 5 choose 0, plus 5 choose 1, plus 5 choose 2, 5 choose 3. All that's left over here is our sum of combinations. And now we see why. When we add a row of Pascal's triangle, we get a power of 2. Notice all we did there was we look at what we're trying to prove and think to ourselves, where have we seen that before? And that led us straight to the answer. So now we have an algebraic explanation for this. Now, other times we've seen cool relationships with combinations. We've also found a counting explanation. Let's try to do that here. What are we counting over here? What are these combinations? What is 5 choose 0, 5 choose 1, 5 choose 2? Well, we can think of these combinations as building committees. 5 choose 0, that's the number of ways to make a committee with no people on it. It's a good committee. 5 choose 1 is the number of ways to make a committee with just one person on it, and so on and so forth. So what this is here is the number of ways to make every possible committee out of 5 people. Because we've covered all the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 person committees. We've counted every single committee over here. So this is, if you had a group of people and you wanted to count out every single possible committee to be made out of some number of those people, there it is. There's all of them. But is that the only way to count the number of possible committees? Well, instead of grouping them like this, where you put all the 0 person committees together, 1 person, 2 person, 3 person, you can think about building your committee another way, kind of take a constructive counting approach to it. Is you line up the 5 people and you ask each one, are you on it? Are you on it? Are you on it? Now, they're all going to want to say no, but some of them are going to have to say yes sometimes. Each person has 2 choices, yes or no, each of the 5 people. So when you're building that committee, each of the 5 people have 2 choices. They can say yes or they can say no. So sure enough, there are 2 to the 5th ways to build a committee of some number of people when you're choosing from 5 people. So there's our counting explanation as well. So now we've shown it with an algebraic explanation and with a counting explanation. Must be true. So that mystery in Pascal's triangle is now solved. And now I'm going to show you another one for you to figure out. All right, so here we go with Pascal's triangle again. And we'll start with 1. Not very interesting. It's a 1. Next row, what we're going to do is we're going to take an alternating sum. First term positive, second one negative, that's 0. We'll do the same thing with the next row. 1 minus 2 plus 1, 0. 1 minus 3 plus 3 minus 1. Yeah, that's 0. 1 minus 4 plus 6 minus 4 plus 1. Minus 4, that's negative 3. Plus 6 is positive 3. Minus 4 is negative 1 plus 1, 0. See a pattern? 1 minus 5 plus 10 minus 10 plus 5 minus 1. Yeah, 1, negative 1, minus 5, plus 5, plus 10, minus 10, 0. One more. 1 minus 6, plus 15, minus 20, plus 15, minus 6, plus 1. What happens here? 1 minus 6, negative 5. Negative 5 plus 15 is positive 10. Positive 10 minus 20 is negative 10. Negative 10 plus 15 is positive 5. Positive 5 minus 6 plus 1, 0. I think you see the pattern over here, right? And it's pretty obvious for some of them. Like these, this one's pretty obvious. They just cancel. This one's pretty obvious. They just cancel. Same thing here. But these other rows are a bit of a mystery. What's going on? What's going on? You know, you look like someone who likes puzzles and likes mysteries. I'm going to leave this one for you to solve. Thank you.